The features of paradise and hell are equally revealed in the world. Therefore, people who don't think of the hereafter or Allah's approval assume all those features of hell. This world turns into a complete hell for them. But if a believer constantly lives with the fear and love of Allah and always reflects on death, then those characteristics of hell are removed from his sight and he sees only the heavenly aspects of the world. His heart and soul literally inhabit paradise and he lives in great comfort. That's why Muslims, believers, have an abundance, plenty and beauty.
Cehennemde bir ateş çeşidi vardır, insanları içten yakar. Yani dışarıda bir alev yoktur.
There's a kind of fire in hell whereby people burn on the inside. We're told there are no flames on the outside, but people will burn internally. People who fall into disbelief in this world, who don't love and fear Allah, live in a state of poor moral, joylessness, unhappily and very and suspicious of all things, in an unbearably troubled state. This is one way that the fire of hell burns from the inside. It burns these people internally. The same thing will apply in the hereafter. In hell too, people will burn on the inside and be terribly troubled and uncomfortable, suffering unbearable pain, although this fire will be internal. There is also an external fire, as you know, normal flames.
Mesela ben soruyorum bazen, sohbet ediyorum gençlerden, kızlardan da erkeklerden de öyle konuştuğum oluyor.
I sometimes chat to young people, boys and girls, and ask them things. I ask them, for instance, whether they have anyone they really trust. To tell the truth, they say, not a single one. I have nobody I trust, they say. I have a genuine girlfriend, but I don't trust her at all. But this is very important. One needs to have friends one can trust as one trusts oneself. Then one can be happy. Otherwise, you spend all your time with people who lie and whom you don't trust. It's like living in a chamber of hell. So, we see the faces of people who live in the chamber of hell. They cannot be happy. That's why it's essential to live tightly by the moral values of the Quran. It's essential to live with the love and fear of Allah. In that event, true happiness can spread across the world and people have a real need of that. In the hereafter, they say that sorrow and regret have got the better of them. When asked why they have come to hell, why they're in that predicament, they say that sorrow and regret got the better of them. That's in the human soul, a satanic feature. They constantly look for sorrow, but never for joy and happiness. They seek burdens, fatigue, and sorrow. They seek a reason to be sorrowful in everything. But a Muslim must seek goodness, beauty and mercy in all things. And since Muslims look for goodness and beauty in all things, their world becomes a paradise. But since people who don't believe in Allah are always sorrowful and tormented, their world is a hell.
Dinsiz olan için zaten ölümle felaket bir başlıyor yani. Ölümden önce de zaten dinsiz.
For irreligious people, death is the beginning of a disaster. Even before death, they burn in this world with the pain of lovelessness and being without passion, of always doubting other people, and with the pain of loneliness, insecurity and selfishness. They are the subjects of many tribulations, though they imagine this to be just part of the normal course of life.